Hey, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. I've got a great video for you today if you're teaching using Zoom. I'm going to go through the 10 golden rules of things to keep in mind when you're delivering a lesson in Zoom. I do loads and loads of training, and some of you will know that some of my videos on YouTube are really popular and have had more than 500,000 plays. So this is based on all the training that I've done with teachers and some of the problems that they have. It includes some really important things like when we screen share, understanding how Zoom shares applications. How does the breakout rooms work? How can we move people around when they're in breakout rooms? I deal with all things from low level to high. It's 10 of the most important things to keep in mind. Really hope you like the video, and if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers. Please, any comments below in the YouTube section where you can put the comments, and let's get started. On to Zoom, the first thing I always say to any teacher is don't work in full screen mode. Exit full screen. Now let me show you why. If I click on the chat window, it opens in the middle of the window. If I click on the participants window, it also opens up in the middle of the window, and that's obviously very inconvenient. So the best thing to do is exit full screen and then just maximize by clicking on this. So you're not full screen, you're just maximizing. Now when you maximize, you'll find that the chat window and the participants list now open here on the right hand side, and it makes it much easier when you're working with your students. So first thing to do, always work in maximized mode. The next problem that teachers have often is that they get confused about how Zoom minimizes. Let me show you what I mean. And there is very important reasons why you want to minimize. For example, you're in a lesson and you want to suddenly open something in the background. How do you do it? You're already on Zoom. Well, there's two ways. One, you can come down to the bottom here if you're working with a PC. I guess the Mac's going to work the same. Click on something in the tray and then open that up. Okay, and then you can access whatever you want. And then get that ready, okay? And then make sure, of course, that you come back to the bottom and come back to Zoom. That's one way, but the way that I normally do it, particularly if I'm not recording, is I minimize. Now, when you minimize, Zoom comes down to just a little box. Now I can do something in the background, and then say, for example, I need to open up YouTube, then I can just simply do it or whatever I need to open up, and then I come back here and I click here, and then it maximizes Zoom again. So a lot of teachers, when I'm having sessions with them, have problems with the minimize and maximize. Second thing to remember is that often when people message you in when you're working with Zoom, if someone messages you privately, then it will change here. And so often what happens is I message someone, so I write a message, okay? And I actually send it, and I don't send it to everyone. I accidentally send it to just one person in the list. Everyone will be listed here individually when they log in. So always be careful when you send a message that you're sending it to the right person. So send it to everyone, or send it to the host, or send it to individuals. So that is the way that you can send a message. So if I now click on that, the message then appears on the screen. But just look out, because this tends to change very easily depending on who sent you a message, and you have to make sure if you want to send a message to everyone that you've got it set to everybody. And when you log into a system, you have got the wrong name, or your students have got the wrong name. There can be lots of reasons for that. They might have logged in using an email address. They might have logged in using someone else's account. So people can overwrite their names easily by just rolling up here, clicking, and then clicking rename, and simply writing in their correct name, clicking on OK, and then it will update on the screen. I encourage your students to do that as well, because it helps you to know who they are. Encourage your students to roll over their names and then click on update name or rename, and then they can obviously put their name in, and you therefore know who that particular student is. Next thing is probably one of the most important. When we screen share, first of all, make sure that you select this button here, because this button here means that it will share both the sound and the visuals of whatever screen you decide to share. So always click on that button when you open up screen share for the first time, okay? Always make sure that that button is selected, because it therefore means that any audio that plays on the video that you're sharing or on anything that you share with your students, they will be able to hear the sound as well. One of the most important things that you can do in Zoom is screen share. That's really the essence of what Zoom is all about, that you can share your screen and share the content on your computer. Now, when you click on the screen share button, what you actually see here is all the current objects, all the current applications that you've got open on your computer. So let's imagine, for example, that I want to share a YouTube video. Well, I haven't opened it up, so of course it's not showing here. There are a couple of ways that I can get to that YouTube video. One possible way is I could simply jump to my, I can see from here what this is, so this is going to take me to my browser. So I click on my browser, so I share that, and then I jump to the YouTube video within that browser. Now, if you want to check that you're still, that your students are still seeing the same thing as you, just click, roll over here and click on new share, and you'll see what they are seeing. So I know my students are definitely seeing my YouTube video with me. Okay, remember again to click on that button. So that's one way of you making sure that you've got the right thing that you wanted to screen share, i.e. you look at all the different applications and you say, okay, this isn't the YouTube video that I want, but I can get to that YouTube video from this application. That's one possibility. Another possibility I'm going to show you. This screen sharing really is a problem. I'm going to spend a little bit more time making it absolutely clear. Let me click again on screen share. What we can see is all the applications that are currently open on our computer. Now, if I go to my internet, or it's Google Chrome, okay, so the browser here, I can see this application. If I click here, it's gonna open that application and it will show me the current tab that is open. If I change the tab, let me just show you this. So if I jump to this tab and then I stop sharing, and now come back to screen share, what you notice is, again, it shows me the current tab that is currently open on my browser. So you may have 10 or 15 things all lined up and ready, but it's only going to show you the one that you've currently got selected. So what I always do when I'm working with screen sharing and working with Zoom is that I prepare all the things that I want to share in advance in tabs. So that when I'm teaching, so let me give you an example. I'm going to open up another tab here and say have Padlet ready. Then I'm going to have another tab ready here, and perhaps I'm going to have Quizlet ready. So I've got all these tabs. Now, they won't all show up in the screen share window. The one that will show up will be the one that I've currently got open. So again, if we come back now, maximize Zoom again, come back to the screen share, I can clearly see that in my internet browser, Google Chrome, the current tab that I've got selected is Quizlet. So I can screen share Quizlet, but of course I can jump to another tab. Okay, now what I can always do to say, well, are my students still seeing this, is just quickly roll here, click on new share, okay, and then just check, are they seeing the same as me? Yes, they are, everything's fine. Now, when you're jumping from one tab to the other, there should be no problem. I'm going to explain in the next part what the problem is sometimes when you're sharing content on Zoom. Now, what I've done is I've opened an internet or Microsoft Edge as well. So I've now got two browsers open on my computer. I've got my Google Chrome browser and my Internet Edge browser, Microsoft Edge browser. And again, because I've opened up a new application, when I go to screen share, so let's just stop sharing and do a screen share again, notice now that that application is available for me to screen share. Now, occasionally, where you get caught out when you're working with Zoom is that you're screen sharing, okay, and you move from one application to another. So I'm screen sharing at the moment Microsoft Edge. I suddenly click on screen sharing Google Chrome. Now, when you swap applications, Zoom doesn't always update. It's okay if you're moving from one tab to another tab within the same application, but when you suddenly jump from screen sharing Microsoft Edge to screen sharing a completely different application, in this case, screen sharing Google Chrome, there can be a problem. So click here, do new share, and just check whether or not the new application is being shared. Okay, so I'm gonna click on here. So I was currently screen sharing that window, but I know on my computer now, I wanna screen share this window. I'm gonna emphasize this point again. When you switch from one application to another application, you must double check that you are screen sharing the correct thing. Because if you remember, it showed that this was the current object that was being screen shared, but I actually want to screen share this. Zoom doesn't do a good job when you move from one application to another. Let me do that again to make it absolutely clear. I'm screen sharing currently, I'm screen sharing this window here. Okay, let's go to a YouTube video. Now, if I suddenly jump to a different application, so in other words, Microsoft Edge, is this being screen shared by my students? The answer is probably no, because we switched to another application. So we need to come down and click on new share and make sure that it is being shared and then click on share again. Now, I don't know the total answer to this question because sometimes it does seem to work and other times it doesn't. Okay, so 100% I'm not sure, but what I'm telling you is every time you switch applications when you're screen sharing, double check that you are screen sharing the right thing. Remember, you can share content for your students to access when you're teaching in Zoom, so you can always share a link to anything that you want them to access, maybe to collaborate on a document or something. Very common for me, for example, is to use Padlet. You can see an example here where I've had a big group of students and they've all been collaborating online. How do I do this? Well, I create the Padlet, simply click on the link, come back to my Zoom session, and then just paste the link here on the right hand side, press enter, and then that will be shared with all my students. And my students can then just click on that link and then access that document. So it's very, very easy to get students to access documents, but it's one of the reasons why it's so important to make sure that the students have got this window open on the right hand side. In other words, they've got the chat window open and they've also got the participants list open. I'm going to go through breakout rooms. All you need to do is click on this breakout room button here, okay, and that will open up the breakout rooms button. Now, in my case, at the moment, obviously I haven't got any students with me, I'm just making this video on my own, but normally it would tell me how many students I've got and I can choose how many breakout rooms I want to create. Say, for example, I want to create 5 breakout rooms, and then I simply click on create rooms. Now, when you click on create rooms, that does not mean to say that the breakout rooms are, the students are already in the breakout rooms. No, what will happen now is that you'll see a list of all the students in each room, and you need to click on this button here, open all rooms. When you click on that button, then it will move you to the breakout rooms. Now, I've got a very popular video on using breakout rooms, which I'm going to provide in the description below. So let's just go through that again. You click on the breakout rooms button and this is what you see. Now notice in this case, I've got 18 students and I'm gonna create 5 rooms and I'm gonna simply click on automatically. And then I click on create rooms. That only creates the rooms now. I still have to actually activate the rooms before the students go into the rooms. Now, once you click on create the breakout rooms, you suddenly get a list of all your students and all the different rooms that have been created. And to actually start the breakout room, you would click on open all rooms. It is also possible to move students. So yes, you've got the breakout rooms organized already, but they're not started until you click on open all rooms. However, you can actually move students around if there are some groups that you're not happy with, because remember, you've done this automatically. So here you can clearly see now that I've got four breakout rooms and I've got the people in them, and I can roll over Sergio's name, and if I wanted to, I could move him to another room or exchange him with another student. So you are able to reorganize your groups if you're not happy with the automated groups that have been created. Once you have clicked on open all rooms, the students will move into their rooms. It will take a few seconds. You can notice here, for example, that no one's joined yet. I've just clicked on open all rooms and I'm waiting for the students now to go into the rooms. Once they've all moved into the rooms, I can easily join any of the rooms by just simply clicking on join, and I will go straight into the breakout room and we'll be able to listen and see what the students are doing. You can also click on the broadcast message button, and that is a great button because you can click on that and then just send a message to everyone and then click on broadcast, and whatever message you write, that will be sent out to all the students in all of the breakout rooms. The options button is very useful. A couple of things I always do. First of all, I always choose move all participants into breakout rooms automatically, really important. Secondly, I often turn off allow participants to return to the main session at any time, especially if I'm working with young students and I want them to stay in the breakout rooms until I bring them back. I turn that off. When I'm working with adults, I often have that on. I don't worry about closing the breakout rooms automatically, and I normally reduce the countdown. Now, the countdown is the amount of time that when you click on close all rooms, it takes, for example, here it would take 60 seconds for everyone to come back to the main room. I often reduce that to about 30 seconds. Hope that was useful. Please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots more free videos. There's a special section on Zoom. If you want to get more Zoom videos, just click there and loads of different videos. If you want to follow my work, please sign up to my newsletter. That way you get kept up to date with all the latest videos, the webinars, the blog posts, and the short courses that I run. And of course, the other thing that you can do is follow me on my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell if you subscribe. Finally, if you want to contact me about me doing some training with your organization or even training on a one-to-one basis, then you can contact me from the website and I can organize a session with you. People are learning things like Zoom and Moodle and Camtasia and Snagit and Edmodo and Google Docs and Google Tools, etc. Then please contact me.